It's really important to look deeper at legumes, not only look at the tops, because that doesn't necessarily reflect what is actually happening with the legume. So one of the first things that we do is check the roots and do a nodule score. So that means you go out into the paddock, you dig up some legumes, wash the root systems and really look at it, how the root system looks like. Is it really nice and flowing with laterals? And then do a nodule scoring. So you line several plants in a row. Basically, you then look at how many nodules there are on the root system and where particularly they are positioned, like you can see in the little scheme. Ideally, you are have a nodule score around 4. Which really tells you that your plant is performing as it should be. Higher is better, but lower obviously is not where you want to be. So then you can have two options. Either you have a nodule score 4 or above, and that means you do have a healthy legume, so the issue lies elsewhere, or you have a nodule score of a 0 to 4, and then you need to obviously investigate that further. So the next step after that, after you've done your nodule score, you can identify with the RASO-ID test which inoculant is actually in your legume root nodules, and that gives you an identification at the maximum capacity of nitrogen fixation that can happen. So once you know that, you know whether you do have the inoculant that is correct for that particular legume species or you don't. So then again, you have to make that decision. If you don't have the right inoculant, then you need to consider re-inoculation or doing some other measurements on farm. But before doing that, you should really check your soil chemistry as well. Important in the soil is the pH, your normal micronutrients, but also the molybdenum nutrient, because that's really important for nitrogen fixation. Rhizobia cannot perform nitrogen fixation if they don't have that element available to them. So look at your soil composition, do soil testing, then also keep in mind the type of chemicals that are used on farm. Be aware that several of them have severe impacts both on the legume plant as well on the rhizobia. Knowing that information, you can then decide on which measures to take to improve your pasture production. So that is either liming if pH is an issue, nutrients or fertilisation, inoculation, and there's multiple ways that inoculation can be done. Or if all of the above fail and you really can't get your soil up to the standard for the legume that you're looking at, there are other species, other legume species available for particular areas, or there might be another issue of disease that is causing the problems with the pasture. So I think that really wraps up, and everybody can do this diagnosis pathway on their own and look for the cause why their pasture is not performing as they want to.